Hello, Book Dragons. It's me, Tegan, and I am back, and I am back with something exciting, and that is my review of Harry Potter and the Cursed Child Parts 1 and 2. Okay, before we dig into this, I just feel the need to sort of give a disclaimer on a few things. Number one, this is going to be split into two different videos. This first video is going to be spoiler free, so if you haven't finished reading, you're fine. I'm not going to give anything away really at all. The second video is going to be more of a discussion because I feel like I have this need inside me to discuss this with somebody who has read it or not, and also to explain myself because I feel like I'm going to say a lot of things that might sound confusing. In this review. Second of all, I have been obsessed with Harry Potter since I was probably around 9 years old. So it's just a wee little thing. It's always been something that I've turned to. When I've gone through hard things in my life, it's just been this strong constant in my life, and it's something that I can turn back to. It's helped me make friends. I was a very shy child. I made a lot of friends through the Harry Potter fandom. It was something that my family and I connected to, and it's just, it's been great. It's been full of role models, people for me to look up to, people who I just completely idolized as a child. I just wanted to make that clear. The last thing that I want to make clear is that I was aware that this was a screenplay. I know that this is a play. I know that a lot of people are really upset about this because they weren't aware for some reason that it was going to be written in script format, so they feel a little bit betrayed. I don't really know what to say to that. I've been aware of it for a long time. I was just excited that this was going to come out because I was heartbroken when I found out that there was a play that I was probably never going to get to go to. So I knew it was a screenplay and it didn't affect my reading at all. I just want to make that perfectly clear. I initially gave Harry Potter and the Cursed Child a 5-star review on Goodreads because it's Harry Potter. It's everything. It's been everything. It's been my childhood. It's been just an enormous part of my life. But then, I mean, I was thinking about it, feeling guilty for pressing the 5-star rating, and something inside my brain was like, just hold on, wait a minute, let's think about it, because I felt this emptiness in the pit of my stomach that was sort of familiar to the emptiness that I felt when I finished the 7th book. Now, the 7th book and I also have sort of an interesting relationship, because while I never seek out spoilers ever, especially for Harry Potter, because it's Harry Potter. And I always went to midnight releases. I was waiting hours and hours in line, like so excited to get the books so that I wouldn't be spoiled by somebody else. Okay, I just want to make that clear. So unfortunately, one of my best friends at the time, well, still my best friend, but still at the time that the book came out, was like, oh my gosh, I just heard all these like really silly rumors. This happens on this page and this happens on this page. And I'm like, no, stop. And she's like, no, it's totally fake. Oh my God, it totally wasn't. So basically the whole of the 7th book was spoiled for me. And I started really realizing that about, I don't know, like 8 chapters in, things had been happening when they said they were gonna happen, and while I hadn't listened to all of the spoilers she said, I did know that Harry was gonna die, but he was gonna come back and all this crazy stuff. So it was kind of just like, it was ruined for me. And then the epilogue was like the cherry on top of the cake. I really, really loathed the epilogue. I thought that it was unnecessary. I kind of just wanted to leave that part up to my imagination, which is crazy because people want more and more, but I don't know, it just felt tacked on and it felt weird. So that's that, just so you're aware. Going to the epilogue, this book takes place, like, leaves off exactly where the epilogue did, or starts off exactly where the epilogue left off. Harry and Ginny and Ron and Hermione are dropping their kids off at the Hogwarts Express for Albus, Harry's son Albus Severus's first year at Hogwarts. And that is all I'm going to really get into it. I mean, if you've read the epilogue, you know that Elvis is super nervous about going to Hogwarts, about potentially, like, I mean, is he gonna be a Gryffindor like his dad? Is he gonna be able to live up to his dad? And so obviously he's kind of freaking out about that, and we read all about that in that blog. So that's all the further I'm going to get into it. I guess one thing that I want to mention also before I get into the grading for my review, because you know I always grade, is that this is based on an original news story by J.K. Rowling. It is not written by J.K. Rowling. It is written by John Tiffany and Jack Thorne. Which is interesting because I, for some reason, was under the impression that J.K. Rowling had written the screenplay. I know that that's not really her thing. I know that she's a writer, but I know she's not, like, she doesn't write screenplays generally, at least not to my knowledge, but I, for some reason, was under the assumption that she wrote this. So, I don't know. I do think she wrote the screenplay for Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them, which is probably why I was confused. I'm not sure. So that was there. And when you read it, you can tell that it's not her, which is one of the things I'm going to talk about. I also just want to flip this book over so that you can see the back, and it says The Eighth Story, 19 Years Later. That is probably the part of this I have the biggest problem with, and I'm going to explain that in a little bit. Into the grading. For plot, I gave it a 2 out of 5. I'm not going to give away any of the plot in this video because I feel like that's unfair. I feel like if you know from the get-go, everything happens very quickly in this book. Years go by in the blink of an eye. So if you know how it's going to start, you kind of have a feeling of how it's going to go. So I'm not going to explain it, but I'm just going to tell you that it felt a lot like going to the new Star Wars movie and realizing that it was kind of like the same story all over again. For characters, I gave them a 2 out of 5. Characters were the biggest disappointment for me. Again, I will be explaining that in my next video, but I just do not want to spoil it for you guys because Harry Potter spoilers are like the saddest thing in the world. So the characters felt off. It was like this crushing disappointment for me. My two favorite characters were the strangest to me, the most unfamiliar, and as I said before, reading Harry Potter always made me feel like I was going home, and it always felt like a safe place, and it just felt completely unfamiliar. It just didn't feel right. Maybe growing up makes people unrecognizable. I would like to think that that's not true, but maybe it is. For the pacing, I gave this book a 3 out of 5. It was okay. It was just okay. A lot of stuff happened in a very little time. Years went by in a flash. I mean, it's just over 300 pages. It's a very fast read because it's a screenplay. It's not a regular novel. So, whatever. The cover is a 5 out of 5 because it's beautiful, and I like that it doesn't match the rest of my set because I don't think that it should. I'm not going to count it as part of my other set. I'm just going to count it as like an extra. For the writing style, I gave it a 5 out of 5. There's no beef here. It wasn't Rowling's work, so I can't really compare it. I don't feel like that's fair. And then for enjoyment, I gave it a 3 out of 5 because it was just okay. There were parts where I laughed. There were times that I was happy, but I mean, it just didn't feel like coming home to me, and that's what I was craving. For not having a story for so long, for the amount of times that I've read through the series and loved on these books, it just didn't feel... It didn't feel like the same universe. It didn't feel the same at all. Would I still jump at a chance to see this live? Absolutely. But do I consider it the 8th story and final chapter of this journey? Absolutely not. I just don't think that that's possible. So for a total, I'm giving it a 3 out of 5. If you have finished the book, I would encourage you to watch my second video where I'm gonna go into some spoilers, because I would kind of like to have a discussion with people who've read this. Like, I really want to know what you think. I want to know if I'm just crazy or like what's going on. So let me know. I'm not upset about this book. I just want that to be known. I'm not upset about it. It's just I went into it with both really high expectations and really low expectations, because it was Harry Potter, I thought it was gonna be amazing automatically, but lower expectations because, you know, it's been a long time since the story's come out. I knew that it was coming out as a play. I don't have a problem reading plays, so I wasn't worried about that. It's just, I don't know. I say I don't know a lot when I get flustered, so sorry about that. Anyways, that is my review. I want to know, without spoilers, what you thought of it, or what you are expecting from it if you haven't read it. Let me know in the comments below, and I will see you shortly for the next video. Thanks. Bye.